It's a building that seems unreal. The work of a mad architect built by mistake. On the edge of the medieval town of Rottweil in southwest Germany stands one of the country's tallest towers. Standing over 246 meters high, it looks like the mast of a wind turbine to which someone's forgotten to attach the blades. Another curious detail is that it's impossible to discern a single window on its facades, except on the top floors. This place seems deserted by life, but then, why was this tower built at great expense to be inaugurated in 2017? Like them, nearly 20 towers around the world seem to defy the clouds for no apparent reason. Others are even true underground skyscrapers, deeper than the Eiffel Tower. All are in a fierce race for grandeur, but to what end? Places empty of any offices, housing, hotels, or other businesses, but which nevertheless serve a very useful purpose, as we shall see in this new episode of Looking For, which promises to be stunning to say the least. To understand this story, we need to go back in time to 1854 in New York. In November 1853, the young American nation hosted its first World's Fair, held for the most part in the New York Crystal Palace. Although the exhibition was a success in terms of attendance, it wasn't until May 30, 1854, that the most striking invention took place. On that day, the American Elisha Graves Otis stood on a freight elevator parked a few meters above the crowd. The inventor had come to prove to the world the reliability of his latest discovery. So when his assistant cuts the rope holding the platform in the air, it doesn't collapse. Defying gravity, it descends a few centimeters before stabilizing. Sorcery? Magic trick? Not at all. Elisha Graves Otis had just demonstrated the safety brake system he invented. It holds the platform in place, preventing it from crashing to the ground. It was a stroke of genius and a real thunderclap for the whole of mid-19th century society. Those lucky enough to attend the event were treated to a demonstration of the first essential system, foreshadowing the arrival of the elevator. Today, the object's part of our daily lives, but it also opens up new doors that were unimaginable at the time. With such equipment, it became possible to build taller buildings, which would radically change the face of our cities. 3 years later, the first passenger elevator was inaugurated in a commercial building in New York. The hydraulic elevator was invented in 1867 by Frenchman Félix Léon Adou, whom he called the ascensor to describe his invention. And as a symbol of its expansion in 1889, five hydraulic elevators, the fastest and most sophisticated for their time, were installed on the iconic Eiffel Tower. A mark of the invention's expansion across the continents, and a great success for the Frenchman, who shared the benches of the prestigious École Centrale alongside Gustave Eiffel. So that's the historical recap, but what's the connection with our huge tower in the open countryside of southwest Germany? Well, to find out, you'll have to go inside the building. Once through the front door, you can appreciate 12 immense shafts, all serving a single purpose: to test the latest elevator models in real-life conditions. Named TK Elevator Test Term, this immense tower is owned by German manufacturer TK Elevator, which has supplied elevators for iconic skyscrapers such as the One World Trade Center in New York. The company also has test towers in Atlanta, Georgia, a 138-meter structure located in the Battery, home of the Atlanta Braves baseball team, and in Zhongshan, China. At 257 meters, the latter is almost three times taller than the Statue of Liberty. In a way, these buildings are the state-of-the-art version of Otis's 1854 New York demonstration. Of course, the idea here is no longer to create a promotional stunt for his invention, but the essential point remains: to prove the reliability and safety of elevators, with a test simulating freefall. Real-life checks are also carried out, for example, on the emergency braking system or the safety device, which are activated to bring the elevator to a safe stop. It should be noted that real elevators are not usually used for this test, but rather an object of equivalent mass. Test sites have evolved according to the objects to be tested. Today's towers, for example, are getting bigger and bigger as elevator speeds increase. Elevators today move at high speeds, in excess of 9 meters per second. To test this type of model, you need to have the time and space to accelerate to maximum speed, but also to decelerate. And some can even go faster. Those developed by Mitsubishi for the Shanghai Tower can reach the incredible speed of 74 kilometers per hour, or 20 meters per second. They're still the fastest in the world today. Pretty handy when you've got to move around a 632-meter tower. The Shanghai Tower, China's tallest skyscraper, is also a construction with many secrets, requiring a wealth of engineering skills to bring it to life. If you're interested, I've included the video I made on the subject in the description below. But back to Germany, to the TK elevator test term. Here, elevator tests can be carried out at speeds of up to 18 meters per second, according to the construction company's website. Three 100-meter-long shafts are dedicated to innovative systems. Even if it still conceals some secrets, which we'll see at the end of the video, this tower isn't the world's tallest building dedicated to elevator testing. It's located in China, more precisely, in the city of Guangzhou, in the southeast of the country. It's the 12th tallest building in this city full of skyscrapers, and its gigantic transmission and tourism tower, which stands 600 meters above the clouds. Inaugurated in 2020, the H1 tower was built by Japanese conglomerate Hitachi. This unique skyscraper features 15 elevator test shafts, one of which is over 250 meters long. In all, more than 2.2 kilometers of test shafts are available in this structure, often described as the world's tallest elevator test tower. The building is 273 meters high. The total length climbs to 288 meters. If we add the 15 meters below ground level for elevator testing, here, among other things, we test high-speed elevators and those capable of carrying heavy loads. Yet this building is not the world's largest in its category. The winner's not to be found in the clouds, but rather under our feet. Let's head for Finland for a discovery that will take us into the bowels of the Earth. But before we travel to Finland to see this engineering marvel, it's best to prepare for our trip. And that starts with a good mobile connection as soon as we arrive at the airport. That's why I recommend using Aerolo, the sponsor of our video, to avoid the nasty surprise of a huge roaming bill when you get back from your trip. In fact, Aerolo's a handy eSIM technology that allows you to have data in 200 countries around the world. No more roaming fees, no more queuing at the airport to buy a local SIM card, no more struggling to find a strong Wi-Fi connection at the airport. It makes things easier. Trusted by 10 million travelers worldwide, Aerolo is the world's first eSIM store, giving you access to digital SIM cards. I use it personally, and Aerolo has been a great help in staying connected on my travels. It only takes a few minutes to set up and activate, and there's no need to worry about roaming costs or getting local SIM cards. With Aerolo, I can easily make calls and work wherever I am. Best of all, you keep your original phone number. Install Aerolo today so you can stay connected wherever you travel. And via my link in the description or the QR code that appears, you can get $3 off your first eSIM using my code looking4EN3. So don't lose time. In Taitairi, a small town near Helsinki, lies an underground maze that plunges to depths of over 350 meters. In operation for over 20 years, the laboratory set up by the Cone Company is located in the depths of an active limestone mine. Its operation has recently been restructured. It now houses 11 test shafts with a total length of 1.6 kilometers. Here, elevators can be tested over a distance of almost 300 meters. It's a professional facility, but one that also attracts the curious. A unique place that represents a gold mine for elevator enthusiasts, to the point of becoming a tourist attraction in its own right. So much so, in fact, that 110 meters below ground, a museum's been set up to tell the story of the limestone mine, the tools and machines used by the miners, and even a restaurant. According to the Cone Company, some 2,000 visitors come here every year. But you have to go 240 meters further down into the bowels of the earth to reach the end of the test tower, where the temperature is considerably cooler. Innovative systems such as double cabins are also tested here. This is a concept incorporating two cabins placed one above the other, enabling more passengers to be transported, reducing journey times between floors, saving space in terms of installation, and lowering construction costs. Kone is testing many things at this unique site, not only elevator control and traction systems, but also signaling, travel comfort, the influence of air pressure, installation methods, and cabin safety. Expertise recognized the world over. Reference installations tested at Tytiri include the Shard skyscraper in London and the Maka Clock Royal Tower in Saudi Arabia. The latter building, located in the holy city of Mecca, has impressive elevators, but that's not its only special feature. The Maka Clock Royal Tower is proud to have the world's largest clock at its summit, 6 times bigger than Big Ben. If you'd like to find out more, I've also included the link to my video on this unusual skyscraper in the description. For elevator manufacturers, there are many issues to consider if they're to offer safe travel. Like the skyscrapers that house them, this means of transport must be able to withstand violent winds that can cause oscillations. That's why some towers are equipped with mast dampers. Working like gigantic pendulums, they neutralize the vibrations caused by winds and even earthquakes. Around a third of the world's 20 tallest buildings are equipped with them. But for engineers wishing to test elevator technology under extreme conditions, these mast dampers can also be used in the opposite direction, creating vibrations rather than absorbing them. A vibration effect that can be activated in the famous Rottweil test tower in Germany, with which we began the video. The tower is equipped with a 200-ton mast damper suspended from 4 steel cables. The damper is set in motion by 2 motors. The resulting oscillation simulates wind and earthquakes, 2 of the greatest challenges in elevator development. A true architectural jewel, the TK elevator has been designed to be both functional and elegant. Its external appearance bears witness to this. The fiberglass fabric used protects the building from sunlight and wind. Aesthetically, this exterior gives the building an elegant, opaque appearance, a recognizable facade that's contributed to the building's status as a renowned architectural monument. So, it's only logical that the place quickly became a tourist attraction in the region as soon as it opened in 2017. Far from being crazy, the tower's 2 architects, Helmut John and Werner Sobeck, must surely have had this tourist conversion in mind, since at the very top of the building is an observation deck. It's the highest in Germany and offers a breathtaking view of the Black Forest. On a clear day, you can even see the Swiss Alps. This growing reputation is skillfully maintained by the TK Elevator Company, which organizes events including a staircase race, attracting some 1,000 participants every year. And now we've come to the end of our exploration of the mysterious world of elevator test towers. I hope you've enjoyed this singular journey. Please let me know in the comments and by subscribing to the channel. See you soon on Looking 4.